Hi, I'm Rich, and I just got my Inrad filter for Kenwood TS 2000. And it's got step-by-step instructions. I don't think you can see it right now. Also has some very good pictures on what to do, what to look for, and things like this. So it's got really some good things here that helps you. It came with the new filter, which is very big compared to what the old one is. You'll have to put this in a different location. You also came with one wire. I've already cut it in two. I thought, well, I think I'll make a video on this so I can show some other people how to do this. Also, it came with some tape to tape it on to a certain area. Now, one of the main things is after you take your screws out of your chassis and pull the little plug, you'll see in the instructions, get a solder iron, maybe low wattage, that you can put a little, see if you notice this. I don't know. I have a screw here, and I wound this up, but you can tie this onto your chassis, sort of ground it, because you don't want any, you know, loose static or anything. So a solder iron. Another thing is, it's always good to have some solder, just in case. Also, it's good to have some rosin, just some liquid, some rosin soldering flux. And I got this at Radio Shack. One of the things that really helped me was this braid. It's called desoldering braid. And I had a little suction thing, and I was having a little problem sucking some of that stuff up. But this is just, I don't know if it's even going to show. But you can put this around your solder joints, and what I did is I dipped it in the rosin, and it starts sucking it up. And then you can loosen up your solder joint. It takes it up really, really good. Some of the things you might need is a screwdriver, a Phillips, because you have several screws, and make sure it fits. Don't make sure it rounds. You don't want to round your screws. Make sure there's three types of Phillips in case you didn't know, and make sure this Phillips fits your screws because you don't want to round them out, because you have several on the bottom of the cover when you take it off, and you have what, 17 or something on the circuit board. And the instructions will show you all this, or tell you about all this. One of the things I did is I got some small wire. It wasn't stranded, it was just metal, copper wire, insulated. And I wrapped this around my insulation on my little coax wires. That way I was able to solder it into the solder, into the board itself, because you can't really do the shielding in there. So I just wrapped around, soldered on here, and then pushed one of these wires as I had cut it off with some Dykes wire cutters, and pushed it down in there, and then soldered it. Before I did that, I couldn't get the wires in, and so I had a safety pin, and this is sort of my drill, because even though you could see a little light in there, maybe some solder was in the hole. And so I took this and I just sort of moved it back and forth and pushed real hard until I got this through. Once I got this through, I get my wires through. I know it sounds sort of dumb because I'm not a solderer, I'm not an electrician technician. Another thing, if you have a metal watch band, you can take one of these wires, wrap on your watch band, and then the other one, of course, you know, strip it a little bit, tie it onto your watch band, strip this a little bit, put on your chassis, make sure it's, you know, it doesn't have any type of static. What I did is I just got a light like this, because you need some really good light on a little stand. My wife happened to have one of those, and this helps out tremendously. I got one of these at Harbor Freight for a little over $5, and even though it has a has a light. It really, the big light made a big difference on that, and you can really see the circuit board and things like this. So it's now, let's get on to the job of putting it together, taking the old one off, and hope it works for you. That's all I can say. Thanks for watching. Now, it's good for you to watch taking the wick. And what I did is I just put the wick more or less around the spot, not to touch the resistors close by, and then just heat it up, and it sucks it up, just sucks it up. Once you've sucked up all the solder on there, then you can just grab a hold of the part on the other side, and then just start heating it up and pulling. There. And there's where your filter is. So it just has four pins and then the sides. Okay, see this one where it has an X? That's where the shielded area goes. This is where the center line goes. Again, this is where the center line goes. And this is where the shielded area goes. This has sort of a three little notches or something here. Three little notches over here as well. So where the three little pictures, I guess you, around the circle, is where the shielded area goes. When you get ready to solder this, if you notice, one of these pins aren't insulated. It goes right to the mount. If you look at down here, and I don't know if I can show it, this pin has insulation around there. So that's where the center pin will go. This is where the shielded area will go. Again, this is where the center lead goes of the coax, and this will be where the other shielded area goes. So I'm going to get ready to solder these. Yellow wire around here for my ground, so it would go in there a little bit better on both of them. And I soldered over here. Where's my finger? That's not my finger. And that way I can just sort of plug it in there when I soldered it. So I soldered around the shielded area. And I'll probably, since it's a big blob of solder there, I'll probably put some electrical tape around it, just make sure it doesn't touch something. Okay, I got the 17 screws back in, and I put some electrical tape around these connection or wires just to be on the safe side. And the filter itself goes on the bottom of this thing. I put the tape on the bottom, and of course it's sticking up here, right in front of the fan. So that's about it. I'm going to put the lid on and see how it sounds. Thanks for watching. Well, the moment of truth, let's see if we can receive anything at all. Well, we'll just have to check it out. Thanks so much for watching.